walk in the woods, not my home.
You stayed with that detail to dip those machine guns in cotton.
Just gonna stash it here. Don't smoke it by mistake. You wanna smoke some, smoke some. Just save me some.
Nah, no need to trip out on no acid. My booze don't need nobody.
Whoa, whoa. Here I come.
Oh,
here I come.
Oh. Mmm.
Pivoting slightly, as you know, Xbox recently suffered some layoffs, and in a memo to staff, you called it a challenging time for the business. I'm wondering if you could elaborate on what you mean by challenging times and what reassurances you can give to fans and players that Xbox is on the right track.
As somebody who's been on Xbox for an awful long time, it's always a challenge whenever a coworker, a team member, is not going to be on the journey with us going forward. And I take to heart the impact on individuals. I see my commitment and my responsibility as the person who heads the business to create a safe place where people can do their best work. And obviously we have reductions for certain people there. I haven't succeeded at that. My commitment is to the business, to the customers, to the teams. I think running a successful business is part of creating a stable place for our team members. The long-term vision that we have on Xbox of building our experience around the player, allowing creators to build games that can reach players on any screen that they want to go play, giving players different ways to build their library, whether it's buying their games, subscribing to their games, looking at access like xCloud and the work that we do on PC. I'm a strong, obvious believer in that vision. Right now, there's some business that we're having to work through, and part of that is making sure that we have the right resources in the right places to do the best work. And sometimes that means we have to make some allocations, in this case, some reductions. And I don't take that lightly because the impact on the individuals is real. But it is, I think, important for us, for the larger organization that's here, that I put this business in the best stable position I can for what we need to go forward, which in the end should create a better place for the great team members that are here building the things that they're building.
Yeah, as we kind of look ahead to 2023 and thinking about where we are in the...
I need rings, Super Bowl size. I need a fine dime with some Super Bowl thighs. You say you the truth, that's a Super Bowl lie. I flex on a nigga like a super swole guy. You coming to the squad and you super gon' die. I make it look easy and I super don't try. It's funny, everybody always looking up to me, but I've always been a super short guy. Bye.
What's going on, guys? This is JWash412, and sorry it took this long. I've been busy as fuck. Now, everything you just heard in the intro that Phil Spencer said out of his lion-ass mouth, talking about the layoffs and why he had to do this and big decisions and he's sympathetic, fuck out of here. It's all bullshit. I don't give a fuck what his reason is for laying everybody off, right? You laid off 10,000 people while still actively pursuing the ABK deal for 80-some goddamn billion dollars. You cannot justify. There's nothing you could say to fucking win us over and make us think, oh, you're a good guy. If you're actively laying motherfuckers off from the gaming division and then pursuing a gaming deal in gaming for a gaming company, for a gaming fucking developer, publisher, whatever, a big-ass developer, for 80-some billion fucking dollars, for that amount of money, you could employ these guys for like 30 fucking years. So nobody's buying that bullshit, Phil Spencer, about how to make tough choices and have to do what's best for the business and have to do what's, you know, the best shit going forward. Actively trying to spend 80-some billion dollars on one deal that I don't see how the fuck's gonna help Xbox anyway. And then laying everybody off at the same time. He's talking about pushing, you know, his PC, his xCloud, and play on everything. He's talking about play on everything when he wants to fucking buy Activision ABK shit so he can fucking put it on not everything. This dude is legit, man, I'm telling you. I think he's like legit a scumbag. There's no way you can look someone in the face and look a camera in the face and talk to people, your fans, whatever else, and say, you know, that you understand the hard decisions and you feel bad for these people because it has real life consequences. I'll say again, for the last time, next topic. You cannot say all that shit when you're trying to spend 80 some billion dollars on a fucking deal in that division and actively laying off everybody in that goddamn division. Don't try to show some fucking sympathy. If you really care about these people, if you really want to keep their fucking jobs, then stop pursuing the goddamn deal. How about
that?
kind of look ahead to 2023 and thinking about where we are in the current console generation, I'm just wondering if things have kind of unfolded as Xbox expected. It seems like there's been a lot of variables so far.
Fuck yeah, there's a lot of variables. The main one being the lack of fucking games. That's the only variable they really got to worry about, is the lack of first party games, the lack of fucking quality first party titles. That is the fucking brunt of their problem.
It's definitely, there's been a lot going on. You think about the last few years and stuff that all of us have had to deal with. In terms of where we are as Xbox, I'm incredibly confident in the plan that we have, the strategy that we have.
Bro, what fucking plan? What strategy are we talking about here? Now, I know that he has to say this shit. He has to say this shit. He cannot come out and be like, well, really, I think we're fucked. I think Xbox is a dying brand, and I think we're about to go out of business. He can't say that shit. But what the fuck is the strategy? What's the plan? To fucking release games on Game Pass here and there at the same quality as something like Hi-Fi Rush and Pentiment? Or, you know, maybe Starfield is your biggest fucking game? Starfield is not going to be the game that people think it's going to be, okay? It's going to be another fucking generic fucking Fallout Bethesda game. That's what it's going to be. So their plan going forward, man, they fucked themselves entirely. This Game Pass model going forward, it cannot work. They feel confident with their strategy going forward. The strategy is Game Pass, and it's proven that Game Pass is not fucking working.
We had a meeting with the entire team, and we talk about our path forward. We're in the entertainment industry, and the entertainment industry is one that's built on hits that aren't always predictable. We're, like you said, we're seeing that right now with Hi-Fi Rush.
Okay, now, Hi-Fi Rush is not a fucking hit. It's a decent little game. It's a decent little game made by Tango Gameworks, who I would much rather have to fucking do it Evil Within 3. But come the fuck on now. This is a surprise hit. Yeah, how many copies does this fucking game sell? Phil Spencer? How much fucking money you make on this game? You know what else Phil Spencer thinks is a surprise hit? Vampire Survivors, Peppa Pig, Pentiment. Those are his ideas of surprise hits or fucking sleepers or games that fucking people want to play. And like, I can't fucking stand it, bro. Hi-Fi Rush is an okay game, but it's not what the fuck Xbox fans want. It is not why people bought a fucking 12 teraflop machine in the next generation is to play something like Hi-Fi fucking Rush. Enough with the fucking bullshit. It's a decent game, but it's not fucking it. It is not what we fucking expect at this point. If you want to give us Hi-Fi Rush after we get a fucking banger, after we get a big AAA fucking release, taking advantage of the console, and taking advantage of the fucking hardware that we fucking paid for, then yeah, then release a Hi-Fi Rush. But Hi-Fi Rush is not a goddamn sleeper hit. It's not a goddamn hit for Xbox. Even though you got all the journalists and all that shit kissing their ass, all the YouTubers, stop it. Stop overrating that shit, just like Pentiment. Pentiment got like a fucking 90 on Metacritic. Fuck out of here. Game Pass filler bullshit is what it is. Hi-Fi Rush is not that great of a game. If you got no games for a year, yeah, any fucking game they give you is gonna feel like, gonna seem like a great fucking game. Same thing with if you're starving, so if there's your goddamn cookie, or whatever the fuck, it don't matter if it's a goddamn crumb, whatever. You're gonna think it's the best tasting shit ever. That's the fucking what's going on here with Hi-Fi Rush. They give you a little taste of something, and now people are eating the fuck up, think it's the best shit ever. And next is gonna be Redfall. That game's gonna be mid as fuck, and people are gonna think that thing is the best thing ever. You can probably have journalists fucking praise the shit. Garbage, bro. Start telling them that this shit is mediocre or subpar, and maybe they'll get the fucking message. But when Xbox releases games like this, subpar or mid games like this, and we praise this shit, giving it 90s on Metacritic, and tell them it's the best shit in the past so-and-so years, this thing looks great on my old fucking 4K OLED, then they're gonna keep on making shit like that.
Absolutely, but I'm gonna start, because I think sometimes it gets a little bit lost in the discussion about Halo and 343, which will always be iconic for Xbox. It's just the launch of Halo Infinite a little over a year ago, and the quality and of execution that team put into the game. I thought it was fantastic, and it's a business that is driven by heart, of people falling in love with the things that you're building, and also being persistent and being brave. as an organization. And this team.
Bro, what the fuck are you talking about? She asked you about Halo and the hit and about fucking Halo going forward and what's going to be the thing going forward and about how they came out with a statement saying that they'll always be here to make fucking Halo here going forward about 343. And he's talking about, I don't even know what the fuck. He's talking about being persistent and brave and how this shit is high quality. Oh boy, let's continue.
It has done some things that maybe weren't expected of them in terms of things like Game Pass and xCloud. And when I look forward at the games that we're building and the platform ambition that we have, and the, you know, it just gives me more and more confidence in where we're going. But definitely the game industry is not one for the faint of heart.
You hear this shit? This man is happy with Halo. This man is content with what 343's done with the Halo franchise. He's content with it. So for all you Halo fans out there who hate this game and hate where the fuck Halo has become and hate what the fuck it's fell into, that's your man right here. He's happy with the effort. He's happy with the product. It's all good to Phil Spencer.
It's not one for somebody who teams that want to play it safe. And I love the ambition that Team Xbox has, and it's a privilege to be part of this team.
Truly, the games industry is not for the faint of heart. I can attest to that. But focusing very briefly, specifically on 343, I think there's been a lot of questions about its role going forward, because it's been particularly impacted by the layoffs. They released a statement saying that they will continue to develop Halo now and in the future, but amid the cuts, and we're given to understand that support studios or additional help may be brought in. I'm just curious, can you shed more light on 343's role going forward?
Obviously, we're talking about the following year, and I'll go into, I think there are some missteps that we made as a team, absolutely. But I don't want to take away from the fact that the team did a really good job delivering a great Halo game. I think reviewers commented on that. We definitely saw players last year playing and the success that that game had. At the same time, when we launched that game.
We definitely saw players last year playing, end quote. We definitely saw players last year playing and all the success we had. Both fucking wrong statements. All the players, how many fucking players is that? 200 players? 300 players concurrently? And all the fucking success that they had. Jesus Christ, man. This man is good. He's good.
We know we needed to make some commitments to people about the content updates and our timing on those and the quality, and we didn't hit our own bar for doing that. And I believe in the team that's there, Pierre and the leadership team and the plan that they have. Pierre Heinz, he's the studio head now, has been on Halo for a long time. He's worked on Master Chief. He's done some great work there. The team has a very good plan. And what we're doing now is we want to make sure that leadership team is set up with the flexibility to build the plan that they need to go build, and Halo will remain critical.
All right, bro, shut the fuck up. This guy's just babbling on and on about fucking nothing and giving no real goddamn answer. Halo's gonna fucking suck. 343 does not know what the fuck they're doing to Halo franchise. That shit's been dead ever since Bungie left it. Whether you want to believe that shit or not, if you're a Halo fan, you know the goddamn truth. That game has not been the same since fucking probably Halo 3. Just is what the fuck it is. Halo, like Gears, will never ever return to its former glory because the people who fucking handle those games now fucking suck and don't appreciate the IP, and don't appreciate its material, and don't know what the fuck and how to make a good goddamn Gears or Halo game. Fuck 343.
Are painful, but I think necessary, but it's really to set us up and the teams for long-term success. And I look at 2023. I love the games that we have coming out. Redfall and Starfield, as you commented, will be exciting just given the timing power with Bethesda now that they're kind of fully integrated into the organization. When I think about the rest of the work that we're doing this year, it's going to be an exciting year. From a production standpoint, we're coming out of all of the COVID at home and at think we've got a better one.
Whomever may dare to challenge us.
All right, man, that's about the end. That's about the end of the video here. Of course, he's gonna go to that whole shit about, you know, how COVID stopped the fucking production. COVID was a problem. COVID. I'll tell you what. Nintendo and Xbox had no, or fucking sorry. Nintendo and PlayStation had no goddamn problem putting out games during the pandemic. Last year they put out, what, Horizon Forbidden West, fucking God of War. Nintendo put out fucking Bayonetta and all these other fucking great games. So it's just continuous, just again, with the motherfucking excuses, man. 2023, it's not going to be a good year for Xbox. If we're just getting fucking Starfield and Redfall, trust me, those games are not it. Those games are not fucking it. Me as an Xbox fan, that's not what I want to see. Just that anyway. Where the hell are all these other games at? We need something fucking hardcore, man. We need something to bring the spirits up of the Xbox fan base. Something real. Not any fake hype shit. Because no real Xbox fan is fucking super hype about Redfall. I'm not saying they're only an okay game to play with your friends. But that's not one it's like, yo, I gotta have that shit day one. Uh-uh. No. I'm talking about a game so good. I'm talking about a game so good, like you're like, damn, you know, I might take vacation for that game. I might have to call off of work for 2 days just to fucking play that at midnight, because that's all I'm going to do. No one's calling the fuck off for Redfall. No one's calling the fuck off of work for Starfield. Are you kidding me? So get ready, guys. 2023. Good luck. Have fun. That's it for this time. Enjoy this video. Like, comment, subscribe. All that bullshit. Tell you guys next time. Thanks.